Okay. We're here with Jared, our under-19s coach. Mate, the boys played Caboolture today at home. How do you think the team performed today?
I think they performed amazingly, to be honest. We had probably six of our regular players out this week, and I said to the boys at the start of the match, I said, look, we need to prove to ourselves that we've got good depth. You know, there's a lot of guys that generally miss out because of the numbers that we have. You know, we've got 21 signed players, so today we only had 17. So the boys that don't normally get a run got a fair run today, and I think we proved that we had great depth. Probably a few too many points leaked, I guess, with having 14 or 16 points against us, but we scored 46 and they dug deep, you know, and the ones that don't get a lot of game time went out there and proved their worth and showed that we do have good depth in this side. So yeah, really pleasing.
Excellent. And what adjustments did you make at half time that made a difference in the second half?
There was a couple of adjustments that I had to make, not by choice, but we lost our hooker, we lost Junior with a bad ankle injury, so put Casey in there. Casey's sort of missed the fix. He's been doing really well out in the outside backs. He scored nearly 14 tries the fixture season, so we put him in at hooker, and we didn't really lose any momentum at all. I thought we'd done a great job. So yeah, just not by choice, we had to make a few changes there, but when we did make those changes, the boys all stepped up and got the job done. So.
Alright, what did you learn from this game, and how will you use the knowledge going forward?
I just learned that the ticker that these boys have, you know, and that's why the, you know, I believe what rugby league has over sports is that you really got to dig deep at times, and they prove that. I haven't questioned their ticker, but they went out there today and proved that we can do it. So if we're up against it again, looks like, well, we do have a week off, but we're not sure where our injuries sort of sit. So we'll assess that, and I know that in a fortnight's time when we play Caboolture again, we're playing them here, that we'll have the side to go and do the job again. So
awesome. And what's your message to send to the fans after today?
Thanks very much for the support. I know it's a reunion today. The 2013 grand finalists are here, so we'll stick around for the presentation tonight and make it a good one for them. It's important that we pay respect to those players that have come before us and so forth. So the crowd's starting to build now. The girls are playing. Got two more games after that. And hopefully everyone gets back up to the clubhouse for a few beers or a few soft drinks.
Awesome. Geordie's our under-19s captain, mate. How would you assess the team's overall performance today?
I reckon it was really good. We started off pretty slow, but we got into the groove, finished off really well, so proud of the team, good effort.
Awesome. As a captain, what were your main objectives and how do you feel like you went?
I was just trying to follow coach's game plans, play simple, because we've got a couple of players out, so stick to the game plan. Just the key, stick to our edges, and just go on from there. I was happy with my running game today. It was pretty good in my kicking game.
Awesome.
3-2-1, Scotty.
That was the same question. What were the challenges posed by the opposition and how did your team adapt and overcome?
Well, in the first half, it was about late in that first half, they got a roll on, they just kept me on a roll on. We dropped down a bit, so I think we just needed to pick our defence back up there and stop being so lazy in the middle and got back up, so it was good.
Awesome. And what's your message to the fans, mate?
Go the Finnies!
We're here with Jeff Wheeler, our Div 1 women's coach, mate. Tough game up against Caboolture today at home. How do you think the team performed?
I thought we did really well against a pretty big Cabo pack. And we got the draw. I think we could have played a bit better. Just made a couple of errors in our own zone. And yeah, we just tidy a few things up and we'll be fine.
What adjustments did you make at half time that made a difference in the game, mate?
I just told them they had to muscle up a little bit, and some of their defence in the first half was a bit soft, and in the second half they did muscle up, but they still made the errors, so that's what we've got to work on.
How important was the draw today? I mean, you didn't take a loss, but you also didn't win, so how was that and how will it impact your season?
The draw actually gets us into the President's Cup, so we're happy with that, but I would have rather the win, but impact on the season, it doesn't have a lot. We know where we've got to improve against them next time, and we're pretty confident that we can come away with a win next time.
Excellent. And what's your message you'd like to say to the fans, mate?
Mate, stick with the women's team, mate. We're going to be the first one to win it for you, for Kawana. Thanks, yes. Guys.
Are you going to ask
them? Yeah, I'll ask them.
Oh, I can see myself. That's shame.
We're here with Brooke Kingdom, our ladies captain. You had a tough game against Cabo today. How would you assess the team's overall performance?
I think we did really well. The only thing that we were let down in was just our mistakes and our discipline, I think. I think if we can get that better next time, I think we can get over Cabo next time. But I think our attack was pretty good. When we had the ball, we seemed to move it around and we got points when we needed to. So not too bad.
Awesome. And as the captain, what were your main objectives and how do you feel like you went in the game?
Yeah, I think I went pretty good. I think I was leading the team around the park, you know, the best way I could possible. I was trying to keep the girls positive when we were behind at half time. And I think that really helped. And just stuff like that.
Excellent. What were the challenges posed by the opposition today and how do you overcome them?
I think the challenges were that they have more size than us, that their girls are a lot bigger than our girls, I think. But we handled it really well. I think in the first half, we were a bit standoffish, but come second half, we were giving it back to them. We weren't letting their big girls run through us. So that was definitely the biggest challenge. But we overcome it when we needed to and we held on.
Excellent. What do you want to say to the fans?
Up Kawana! Fins up!
With Chris Corbett, our stand-in Div 2 coach today. Mate, we had a cracker game against Caboolture. How do you think the team performed?
Yeah, they performed pretty well. They stuck to the game plan in the start and got on top. Then a little bit about midway through the first half, we sort of led them back into the game. We probably didn't fatigue them like we were talking about, but come second half, I think they come away with it, started finding their weaknesses and opened them up a bit, so yeah, it was pretty good.
What adjustments did you make at half-time that made a difference in the game?
Oh, we didn't do any adjustments at half-time. We kept that same side back out there, and I think that was pretty good. And, you know, went back to our starting sort of line-up toward the end. We sort of showed a little bit. We had to take a couple of players, Jacko and Sato off, just so they're backing up for A-grade. So there was a little bit of adjustment through the second half, but I think the likes of Ollie Fraser, you know, a bit of a standout, hit those up, put him in the back row, and just real good combination with Jacko there in about midway through the second half. So yeah, opened him up. Akers played off the back of that and worked their right edge. It was pretty good.
Awesome. And what message would you like to send to the fans today, mate?
Fans? Message to the fans: get down here, support us. Make sure you're playing some good football at the moment, and there's a good A grade going on now, and there's another couple coming up, so get down here and have a few beers and enjoy it.
Thanks. We got Riley Arthur, our Div 2 vice captain, mate. Strong game against Caboolture today. How would you assess the team's overall performance, mate?
A lot happier with it this week. We seem to fully gel, and everything seemed to work a bit smoother than the weeks coming up to this, so I was happy. We put together a full performance.
Awesome. And what were your main objectives and strategies going into the game? How do you feel like you played, mate?
I feel like I was a bit overexcited at the start. Wasn't used to being in space so much this year, so I pushed the pass, but other than that, once everyone got into the game, it was good. The connections you could see started to build as the game went on. And I was happy with how me and Tommy worked together, so it was good.
And what were the challenges posed by the opposition that you had to adapt to, mate?
There were some big boys out there. It wasn't easy just taking a hit up into them, so that would have been the biggest challenge for sure.
Definitely. And anything you want to say to the fans, mate?
Always thank you for coming out. It's always a better atmosphere when there's a bunch of you down here, and it's a lot more fun, so we appreciate it. Thank you.
Mate, we're here with Andrew Hinson, our Div 1 men's coach. Mate, tough game against Caboolture. Boys look like they really stood up. How do you think the team performed today?
Really good, mate. Yeah, happy with that. Our discipline at times still needs a little bit of work, but look, we're back in our defence and it's really showing. So not only 10 points again this weekend, this game finished off the half there with, you know, three or four sets on our line, and I know they got the try in the end there, but it was some really good work. So yeah, really happy with where, how we're heading.
Excellent. What adjustments did you make at half time to make a difference in this game?
I don't know, no real adjustments at half time. We just spoke about maybe playing through the middle. We didn't get a lot of opportunity to do that in the second half, but we thought there'd be guys, if we could send a bit of traffic through the middle, they might knock up a little bit. We felt we were trying to get on top of them late in that second half, which we did, but it didn't go our way for the majority of that second half. We were coming off our own end, but half time we spoke about mostly, just trying to work through those middles. So I thought our defence was really good for that first half, so boys are pretty happy. Just a few discipline, a few things like that we just need to fix up.
Excellent. And how important was it for the team to win today, and what's it do for your season?
We keep in touch with the top few teams, which is good. We're not too worried about that, where we're sitting on the ladder or anything. It's just good to keep rolling forward, which we're doing now. So starting to get a bit of consistency in our efforts, which is good. So puts us in good stead for the back end of the season, and hopefully we're all fit and healthy at that time of the year and putting our best foot forward.
And this one, I just want to yee-haw, fins up, kicky, kicky, kicky.
I can't do the kicky.
You can. You can do anything.
I can't. I maybe need some help.
Make anything. All right. What message would you like to send to the fans for today, mate?
I just want to say a big congratulations to Josh Sondergill and also Benny Whitten.
For still standing.
But yeah, for still, they're the biggest bet. Frank the Tank's on his way. Good atmosphere here tonight, which is good. We've got our 2013 grand final team, which is great. Their 10-year reunion, so it's we just need it's good. Hopefully get the boys, we've got to hopefully get the crowd in next week. We've got another tough one against Coolum, so if we get the boy get all the crowd in to celebrate that, that'd be awesome. And get from there, fins up, eh?
Luke McBeth, we had a strong game against Caboolture today, mate. How would you rate the team's performance overall?
Mate, yeah, pretty good, I reckon. We've been sort of building the last couple of weeks, and I think tonight was good. Once again, sort of a bit patchy, probably discipline once again, but honestly, that's like we can work on that. I think it was a good performance. We scoreline, we let them in there right at the end, which is a little bit disappointing, but we defended our line there for a lot on the back of our disciplinary errors, but yeah, I think we're going all right, so it's good.
Excellent. As the captain, what were your main objectives and strategies going into the game? How's your game go, mate?
Personally or as a team?
You personally.
Oh, mate, personally, I would try to lead the boys, I think, through the middle there and try to get through a fair bit of work, which I think in patches I was fairly happy with how I went tonight. Still a lot for myself to work on, and then as a team as well, I think in attack as well, we've got a lot to do, but I think we're getting there, so no, I was happy with my performance tonight, but yeah, still a lot to go.
Excellent. And what were the challenges posed by the opposition today that you've had to work on and overcome?
Mate, I think the biggest challenge was ourselves. Like I said earlier, just discipline. But they're a strong side. To their credit, they didn't go away. We when we had the footy and like got a bit of good ball, we sort of were putting some points on there. But they kept going. To their credit, I think just they hung in there. They were tough. But yeah, well, like I said, I think it's ourselves that we need to fix. But I think we'll be right.
Something good to work on a training there for you next week.
Yeah.
Mate, last one, what do you want to say to the fans for turning out today?
Thanks heaps. Let's keep it going, eh? Let's get more and more here every week and finish the year strong. Not this time, John.
I haven't heard the end of it since the last one.
Just need to make a special announcement tonight. One of our players has cracked or equaled the record. The player that's been with us for a long time, played 200 games for the club, which is a massive effort. That equals Rixie's record, and he's here tonight, which is great to see. Thanks for coming, mate. If you look at the games played, there's some Kawana legends up there, and it's a really good group to be a part of. So this guy, over time, has worked his way up into that level, and when his name will match the players that are up there. So 200 games for this great clubman, Shaun Smith. Happy birthday.
I've looked up to them, they've got their
side and
got
to win
a few premierships
for
them.
But
yeah, nice,
it's
really good to have
them in the room. Yeah. Yeah, congratulations. 200 games here, a great club, that's a massive effort. He's been around forever today, and he's a bit of a more fitting person.
Well done. Good work, Brad. That's it. Yes, Breno. That's it. Yes, Gordon. That's it.